Okay, guys, so this is David Kwon again, continuing on with the Hour of Kwonmunism, and I just now addressed all the comments, or not all the comments, but the interesting comments that I received on my videos this week, and now I think is the time to actually, for me to start sharing my opinions on actual topics. The first thing I want to talk about is, as usual, something that is related to US news and American news, so that's kind of what I want to start on. Let me actually stand up to actually start about talking about topics. So put my chair back here. Alright, so now you can see me standing up. I feel like I'm more pumped up to talk about things when I'm standing up, so that's what I'm doing. So, yeah, last week, President Obama gave a speech about the national security concerns. Three really important things he addressed, or I don't know if the address is the right word to use, but his speech involved topics about drone strikes, use of drone strikes, and, you know, America and drones. So that was topic one. Second topic was Guantanamo Bay, Gitmo. That's important. And then the third, he talked about the American government's involvement with press, namely because of the event, the scandal that occurred with the Fox News reporter and the AP press, Associated Press incident, and such of that nature. So three really important things he talked about in the speech. Where do I begin? Honestly, this speech to me is one of the most disappointing speeches I've ever watched from, you know, that seen Obama do. I mean, I haven't seen that many speeches. I'm not like a White House speech connoisseur or anything, but I felt like this was an interesting one to watch. You know, I usually think Obama is a brilliant politician. He really is amazing when he gives his speeches. This speech, whoever wrote it, was really, it was tricky writing. It really was. And I did a video. I recorded me reacting to an excerpt of the speech. And I think that excerpt, I had no idea, but I just picked that excerpt. But that excerpt, it seems to me, was the weakest part of the entire speech. That's why in my reaction, I was just like, just not enjoying that experience at all. The rest of the speech, particularly the bit about drones, right before the excerpt that I reacted on, I think that was probably the one that was, I feel most good about, or the most optimistic about. I don't know, that speech was just, oh man, where do I even begin? I guess I'll start with the good part. So good part is in regards to drones. I know that's interesting, considering how I really do not like the use of, me personally, using drones, remote controlled devices that are armed with missiles and bombs and machine gun fires and such. Using those kind of devices and being able to just use that to surgically precisely target someone and get the kill order, that is it just irks me in so many different ways. I know conventional warfare, or you know, using black ops soldiers, or using troops or CIA or Delta Force, probably messier, you know? Messier is less, you know, you would have a lot more casualties still, even using methods that doesn't involve drone strikes. But the idea of striking first and killing someone without trying to capture someone is an idea that really, really just irks my, I don't know, this notion of civil liberties. But that aside, and that's why this speech was really disappointing, to see that Obama administration, I mean, of course, I'm not surprised, it's just really disappointing that Obama administration is so defensive, you know, so willing to justify the use of drone strikes in this manner. Not surprised, it was expected, considering how this administration is the administration that really increased our usage of drone strikes tenfold. Okay, that's an exaggeration, but it's, compared to the previous administration, the Bush administration used drones for the first time, but nowhere near this level. And the secrecy of using drone strikes was not at this level. But the day before Obama made this speech is the day that the Congress passed this legislation about drones, which gave clear guidelines on its constraints, and handing over CIA is no longer in charge of drone strikes. That authority has been now given over to the Pentagon, to the military, which is a, this really shows now the kind of philosophy of the Obama administration regarding drone strike is becoming more formalized, more established, which I think is a good thing. I think, as I said in my reaction video, Obama administration is now starting to cover their ass. What happens when the election happens in 2016 and the next president takes over? And you have this drone strike policy that's kind of like willy-nilly, like do anything you want with them. No, you got to have established set of rules, and that's what they established the day before the speech, which I think is at least a good sign. I read this Mother Jones article about typically, like now the shift is that CIA is gonna be able to focus on doing what it was intended to do, gather information, and it's an intelligence agency. It's not an agency that was designed to determine which targets to strike using drones. That just really overburdened and overtaxed CIA or civilian agencies like CIA. So it's really great that this is moving to the military. Obama is not using war on terror, but is specifically talking about insurgents, Al-Qaeda. So specifically targets, he specifically delineates which kind of targets that drone strikes will target, where it will target. So getting more specific, which is great. This is a good sign. I'm not happy that drones are still being used in this manner and that the administration is still defending it in this manner, but at least there are some steps here. As Mother Jones was quick to point out, that this kind of progress, if you can consider that, was something that you wouldn't have seen under the Bush administration, under Dick Cheney. And I feel like they're right. It's still disappointing, but at least it's a step. The other two issues, Gitmo and the press scandal, I don't see any good signs. Honestly, the Gitmo thing, that was just really, really painful to watch Obama talk about trying to blame everything on Congress. That was, like, what really, like, Obama's like, my hands, like, when I was watching that speech, it just looked to me like Obama was saying, my hands are clean. Look, it's been my promise since I was elected. Before I was elected on my campaign, it's one of what was my main platforms to close down Guantanamo Bay, to close it down and to have a trial process for, this whole authority of president under war, president's war powers and all that. Like, I was against it, and I tried to close down Gitmo, but Congress wouldn't let me because it was, like all these rules and it was politics that didn't let me do that. To which I respond, bullshit. Bullshit, President Obama. Really, that was really disappointing that he just blames everything on Congress. Because that's not true. Like, okay, I mean, sure, there were obstacles, political obstacles within Congress, but it's not like President Obama did anything to stop that, or I don't know. That was really disappointing how he just dumped all the responsibility of closing down Gitmo. So I'm not really feeling an optimistic vibe regarding this issue. I mean, it's better late than never, honestly, to close down Gitmo as quick as possible, and to get this country out of this mess of trying this whole separate justice system or separate martial law system for terrorists or suspected terrorists. It's pretty ridiculous, and it's gotten to the point. It's been in place for over a decade now. So it's great that you give us lip service. President Obama really made a good speech, looking good to the public. Like, yeah, Gitmo is horrible. This is why it's horrible, and this is why I want it shut down. But Congress is not letting me shut it down. bullshit, really. And then the press scandals. That was, Obama flat out lies in this speech. Flat out lies. That was that. So on the issue of drones, I was disappointed. On the issue of Gitmo, I was just like, what? Really? You're just gonna, you know, not take any responsibility or take any accountability? On the issue of taking records, private records of demanding private information and just going against the Fourth, just violating the Fourth Amendment for, and the First Amendment actually, for journalists and journalist organizations, Obama flat out lies. It's just like, yeah, we're gonna have the Attorney General, Eric Holder, investigate, or, you know, overview the investigation done by the investigation team of the civil liberties, whatever, when Eric Holder is the one doing the investigation. So he's like, I don't know. The only good part I saw from this speech, the only positive thing I saw was regarding drones, which is surprising, because I am really, totally, philosophically against the use of drones in this manner. But at least there's now some guidelines. But that was it. National security-wise, Obama's administration is just really, really so not transparent, so secretive, so it feels like status quo from Bush administration, but sometimes a little worse. Sometimes it feels better, but I feel like Obama is just doing lip service on this point. On these issues, it's just so problematic. And, you know, when, because the press, journalists, news agencies are the bastion of dissent, you know, of being able to, this is the information center of knowing what the government is doing. And those are the kind of groups of people that we say, hey, help us to hold government accountable. And now the government is like attacking them, and just really violating their civil liberties. And the response that Obama administration gives in the speech is just like, it's not right, and so we're looking into the matter, and we're gonna investigate it. But it's just, yeah. So honestly, I don't know. I think I made a video that was really cynical about the state of American politics in my last Hour of Kwonmunism, and watching this speech, I that cynicism is still there. It's still there. I am not, you know. Yeah, anyway, this is depressing. Let's move on to the next topic.